Ladies and gentlemen on YouTube, it is the artist formerly known as Natural Born Driller. I already got one album down, Kissland. Next album, Beauty Behind the Madness. So let's not waste any time. You already know what I'm doing here. I need to get to 5 albums. I'm on a road, a journey, a quest to get to Dawn FM. But the only way to do that, I already got Kissland. That's the first thing I already got out of the way. I already give my grade of it, ready to give you my thoughts of it, my review of it, sort of short review in the way. Now Beauty Behind the Madness is next. After that one will be Starboy, and then after that one will be my favorite album of all time, next to Beauty Behind the Madness, which I'm gonna get ready to listen to after hours. So let's get right into it. Starting off first with Real Life. Losers. Tell your friends. Often. The Hills. Acquainted. Can't feel my face. Shameless. Earned it. In the night. As you are. Dark Times. Prisoner. Angel. And there you go. That was Beauty Behind the Madness. Now pertains to the album. I don't recall the Weeknd using the actual words of his album called Beauty Behind the Madness, other than maybe beauty in there pertains to women's and all that. I don't know if he ever used madness in there. Maybe he has. I just didn't you know listen to that part of you know all these lyrics and all, but. I guess what pertains to what he talks about here, or sing about, I should say, in here, that there's nothing but beauty behind the madness. But yeah, from 1 to 14 tracks here, you know, they're all pretty good. All of them are pretty good. But if you ask me, you know, which I'm gonna go through here a little bit, Real Life, love the song. It speaks to me, by the way, pertains to real life, you know. I mean, that could be other things for things of real life, other than, you know, something else for things to YouTube, you know, and the YouTubers, but, you know, that's not Tommy, though, you know, you know what I mean? but, yeah, this just speaks to me of real life, you know, in a way, not, you know, so this is a pretty damn good song to open up the album of Beauty Behind the Madness. Next to it was Losers, that feature Labyrinth. Now, I don't know much of Labyrinth, really, but he sounds pretty good, and the song itself was pretty good, too. I love the song, you know. It's a good song to dance to as well, you know. Yeah, I thought it was a pretty good song there that was added into here as well. Not much to say about it. Tell Your Friends, which is, you always hear from me every time on YouTube, more tends to take out the trash, and, you know, now, as of right now moving forward, more tends to go tell your friends about it. It's because this came from the Weeknd of his album Behind the, you know, Beauty Behind the Madness. The song, Tell Your Friends. Go tell your friends about it, to like, subscribe, and to share, you know. And by the way, this whole thing, you know, Friends, honor of Friends, the TV show. Great show, by the way. I love the song too, by the way. Tell Your Friends, you know, there's also some, you know, freestyle in there as well. I mean, if you want to call it a freestyle, but pretty damn good as well. And I, you know, I'm pretty sure it, you know, pertains to the song. It could relate to anyone out there. Pertains to tell your friends, whatever. But you gotta listen to the lyrics itself to understand what this is all about. So, but I enjoyed it though. Pretty damn good song. Next to it was Often. Pretty good song as well. If you ask me, it'd be one of my least favorite to listen to, but I do recommend anyone, if you want to listen to the song Often, go right ahead, listen to that song. It's pretty good. And you know, I would say Losers, you know, it's also gonna be my least favorite to hear too as well, when it comes to the album itself, but I still will take a listen to it. The Hills, damn good song, especially the opener, and then pertains to everything that he talks about, you know, he, you know, freestyling in the way, and then he starts singing, and then the whole Hills Have Eyes and all that. Pretty good song too. And then following that, Oh, by the way, I should point out too, by the way, real life 3 minutes and 43 seconds is the how long the song lasts. Losers, 4 minutes and 41 seconds it lasts. Tell your friends, 5 minutes and 34 seconds it lasts. Often, 4 minutes and 9 seconds it lasted. And The Hills, 4 minutes and 2 seconds it lasted. Following that was Acquainted, which lasted 5 minutes and 48 seconds. Another good song that I love. It's another good song you also dance to as well. When it comes to the ending of it though. Then we get to, it's one of my most favorite listen to basically. Especially when it comes to that song was added to one of Weeknd's albums that came out. I mean, I wouldn't call it an album, but this is one of that it's called The Highlights. But it tends to any of the songs that he did from the past, and then obviously it tends to After Hours. It's all added into there as well. So that was added there, and I'm glad it was because it is a damn good song. Can't Feel My Face. That's a great song. Amazing song. Reminds me a little bit of Billie Jean, because obviously because of the music video, but Can't Feel My Face, it's a story behind that, by the way, but that's for another time. 3 minutes and 32 seconds lasted. A pretty damn good song. A song that I recommend listening to all the time. Shameless. 4 minutes and 13 seconds. Another good song. Again, Routines of Beauty Behind Madness is one of my favorite albums of the Weeknd. Next to After Hours, which once we get to that part, you'll know how I feel about that album too as well. But Shameless is another good song that I love as well. I'll always be there for you. That's on the part always gets me from there. And there's some other things that gets me as well. Pertains to nailing the song for this track. Earn It, which if you remember, 50 Shades of Grey, the movie, this song was all included into the into the soundtrack to the movie. But Earn It, 4 minutes and 37 seconds. Pretty damn good song too as well. One of the songs that the Weeknd used for his Super Bowl performance from last year. And he also used on this song as well, pertains to him being in the Oscars. Don't remember what year it was. I think it was like 2018, I think it was, or 2017. It's been a long time, but it hasn't been that long since he has used it. So, but another good song as well, And following that was In the Night, 3 minutes and 55 seconds lasted. In the Night was another damn good song. There's a lot of things in the song that really gets you into that groove, Especially with the vocals of the Weeknd is what really touched this song as well. Pretty damn good. Following it was As You Are, 5 minutes and 40 seconds. This was one of my least favorites of the song that I listened to, but another good damn song that I always listen to as well. As You Are, and then pertains to what he says for the end, As I Am. Yeah, not much to say about the song other than, it's a good song to listen to, but it's one of my least favorites that I listen to on this album. Dark Times, that feature Ed Sheeran. And if you ever know who Ed Sheeran is, he's a damn good artist. He's the one with the songs of Thinking About You. Wait, I think it's called Thinking About You, right? Or Thinking of You. I'm trying to remember. But it's gonna kill me if I don't remember this one. Let me see. Oh no, I'm sorry, it's called Thinking Out Loud. That's what I meant to say. Pertains to Ed Sheeran, open up the song of Dark Times, and then The Weeknd comes into it from the middle part of it, and then they later on they start doing what they gotta do to make the song work, and it did work in a way, and I loved how the the beep made it so thrilling in a way. That's how I felt with this Dark Times. And then following that was Prisoner. That was featured with Lana Del Rey. Lana Del Rey, who also appears in The Weeknd's album after this, was in Starboy, which seems to the interlude, something like that is called, which pertains to Stargirl. But yeah, Prisoner was a pretty damn good song as well. Another least favorite of mine to listen to as well is Prisoner. But I do love how the song is too, by the way. And then pertains to that you can hear the change in a way, the shackles in a way that goes with the song, which is why it's called Prisoner. And then the final track was Angel. 6 minutes and 17 seconds lasted. Another good song. I listen to it sometimes when it pertains to something that could relate to me in a way. So Angel is another good song from The Weeknd. And it's not just with The Weeknd. This one also sings there too, but I just can't figure out who it is. I don't remember if I ever looked it up to see who else was there. It doesn't even say who it features with of Angel, where it tends to sing this song, where it tends to "I hope you find somebody," and then also make it children's basically from the ending of this of it. A lot of children are singing the song. You when you hear the background of it, and they're singing it, and they're singing. Oh, they were all singing pretty good, So I can't really tell what tends to Angel, how it's supposed to represent, because for those who the Weeknd is about what he does as a magician. All right, we're back. So as I was saying, what tends to Angel being in Beauty Behind the Madness, I don't think it's a it really matched well with with the word angel for a song, especially there was nothing dark about Angel to add to Beauty Behind the Madness, other than maybe the music, other the way it was done to and all, but especially when you got children singing in there, a woman singing there, which I'm pretty sure is maybe as an angel singing. I don't know. Maybe on the lyrics, that I probably even noticed it. It was something to talk about it, where it seems angel in there, but but in my opinion, I don't think Angel should have been part of Beauty Behind the Madness. I mean, great song though, great song. Maybe it should have been a single, in my opinion, instead of being in the album pertains to The Weeknd, of how dark he can be and how maddening he can be. So, but that's just me. But I digress. Now, if I have to choose release songs to listen to, if I want to recommend the least to listen to, yeah, I mean you can still take a listen, but what I suggest you actually listen to will be Losers, Shameless, As You Are, Prisoner, and Angel. For my most favorite to listen to that I recommend to any of you wanting will be Dark Times, In the Night, Earned It, Shameless, Can't Feel My Face, Acquainted, The Hills, Often, Tell Your Friends, and Real Life. But if you suggest me of you ask me in a way which song is one of my all-time favorites in this album itself, it'll be Rhapsody number one will be for me Can't Feel My Face. Following that will be The Hills. Then they'll following that will be Real Life, Tell Your Friends. And then I'll also add in there under it Acquainted and In the Night. That's one of my, but if I had to choose one though, the one that I had to choose will be Can't Feel My Face. So as far as the album itself, Beauty Behind the Madness, which is one of my all-time favorites, so I'm gonna give it an A, and which is a letter grade. So that'll be the letter grade for Beauty Behind the Madness. And now what we gotta do now is tune in for the next album, which is Starboy, and you'll find out how we'll find out together in a way of what how great that album is too, and what's gonna be the letter grade for that one. So there you go, folks. Like I said, thank you for watching. For it is the artist formerly known as the Natural Born Thriller. As I want you all to be well, stay safe, take care of yourself, everything that's going on in the world. Wear your mask, get your hand sanitized, wear your gloves, get vaccinated. But of course, it's your choice to get vaccinated or not. Don't let anyone tell you that you can or cannot. So, and at the end of the day, it's your body, your choice. Also, I want you all to be better, be respectful, be appreciative, to love one another, God bless one another, live in peace and harmony for us all. So yeah, I am out here, ta-ta for now. As I say, peace on the streets, and be sure to go tell your friends. Go tell your friends about yours truly. To make sure to like, subscribe, and share. Let everyone know that I'm trying to do the absolute best to give you the absolute best content I can give you right here on the platform of YouTube. Take care.